Yo, what's up, my earthlings and beings? This is Rod D of Orange Ninja News, where news is what we do. All right, but today I'm going to be on a different topic. I'm not even going to go through all the news articles right now. That'll be on another broadcast, you know, do another video. Right now, I really want to talk about, this is to the truckers right now. So if you look for a news video, just catch one of my other videos. So I'm going to talk to the new drivers about backing, because backing is real important. You're going to end up backing your truck all the time, man. Whether you're backing into a dock to get loaded or unloaded, or if you're doing a drop and hook and you're not doing a lap load, you'll be backing into a space, you know, at the warehouse. They say go park it on row 5. You'll drop your empty off there and you pick up your loaded on this other row. So either way, man, you're going to have to know how to back a trailer at some point. And I think the main thing to that is being focused, watching what you do, and always check and double check. Because, you know, some guys, you know, they want to be lazy, don't want to get out and look if it's a tight spot. And I think that's the main thing that it gets somebody messed up or get somebody in trouble with the backing, is not actually when you get the truck turned where you can't see out your passenger side mirror and you know you're between two trucks and the space is kind of tight. Man, just get out, look, you know what I'm saying? It doesn't take that long to get out and look and see what you're doing. I mean, I don't know. That's what they teach in the driving school, is get out and look. That's what the trainers teach, is, yo, you get out and look. But then, when a rookie get in a new world, it's, you know, you out here in the real world and driving, it's like, oh, I don't want to seem like I don't know what I'm doing, or I'm a new guy, so I'm not going to get out and look. Man, even if you've been driving forever, if you're not sure, you get out and look. So it's not, you know, it shouldn't make somebody look at you differently. Like, oh, this guy don't know what he's doing. I see somebody being careful. I see him getting out and look. I'm like, yeah, that person knows what he's doing. He's making sure he's careful. He's not going to just hit somebody's truck. I feel way more comfortable if I see that type of junk going on. Instead of somebody just backing up willy-nilly, it's either they don't care or, you know, we got something's going on in their head. Because we know a lot of these wrecks occur right in the truck stop, man. I mean, you be in your truck trying to get some rest. You're down for your 10-hour break. Next thing you hear, boom, boom, somebody trying to back. Done ran into somebody's truck. Like, man, come on, man. So that's why I say the main thing is backing. So that's why I want to talk about that today. Yeah, it's crazy when you're at a truck stop and there's like row after row after row of empty spaces. If it's during the day, everybody's out working. It's not even that many trucks in the parking lot, because during the day is prime trucking hours. I mean, if you got an appointment at a warehouse, most likely it's going to be in a early morning time or sometime during the day. And hell, even a lot of warehouses are closed at night. So daytime is prime time for trucking. So everybody's out making deliveries and stuff. So if a person pulls into a truck stop, you got plenty of parking, but you still have guys that are parked beside the scale. They're parking the fuel out for a long time while they go in and do whatever it is. You know, some guys even go in, try to take a shower or whatever while you got your truck parked in the fuel out. And it's crazy, man. I'm like, I can see as a new driver, you're really nervous about trying to park your truck or whatever. You're not that good at parking, but during the day is the best time to be practicing, because there's no other trucks out in the parking lot. So you got a bunch of empty spaces. You pick a row of empty spaces and you practice backing, and you're not in danger of hitting nothing because it's a empty row. You know what I'm saying? There's nobody around. You just pick a spot, practice backing into that spot, and just, hell, sit there. You can sit there for a good hour, just keep practicing, and that's how you get good at your craft, man. But instead, I see a lot of guys here just park on the sides. They park by the scale or wherever, and you're like, damn, buddy, I mean, it's a empty lot. Why don't you park in the space? Oh, I'm not that good at parking. Dude, there's no other trucks over there, man. Go practice. How are you going to hit something and it's just row after row of empty spots? That's weird. And never get good if you don't practice.